leader friends. Let's play a game of follow the leader. Do what I do. Ready? This game reminds me of someone in the Bible in today's story who was asked to be a follower. Let's find out. Simon, Andrew, James, and John grew up in a little town in Israel called Bethsaida. Simon and Andrew's father was a fishing partner with James and John's father, and when the boys grew up, they also became fishermen and joined their fathers in the fishing business. One day, they met John the Baptist, who was telling people to be ready for the Messiah. Andrew became very interested in what John the Baptist was saying, so he started following him around to learn more about this Messiah. Then one day, John the Baptist recognized Jesus amongst the crowd and cried out, "Behold, the Lamb of God is here!" John the Baptist pointed the way to Jesus, telling people to follow and listen to him. So Andrew and the other disciples started following Jesus. They stayed with Jesus all day, listening to him and learning from him. And Andrew realized Jesus is the Messiah that God had promised to send as our Savior, that they were waiting for him. Andrew could hardly wait to share this great news. You know, when you have great news to share, who do you want to tell first? Probably your family or your close friends. And that's what Andrew did. He rushed home as fast as he could and found his brother Simon. He said to Simon, "We have found the Messiah. He's here, Simon. He's here." Quickly, Andrew brought Simon to Jesus, and Jesus knew everything about Simon before he could even say anything. Jesus knew that Simon was an impulsive man, meaning Simon tend to say things and do things before thinking about it. Simon must have been surprised that this man who he has never met, this Jesus, knew exactly who he was. Simon must have also been surprised that Jesus said that Simon's name would be changed. Jesus changed Simon's name to Peter, which means rock, because Jesus was going to change Simon into someone who would be steady, strong, and firm like a rock as he followed Jesus. But you know, following Jesus around physically isn't everything. You have to listen, believe, and obey Jesus. One day, Jesus told Peter to let down the nets to catch fish from his boat. But Peter replied, "Master, we've worked hard all night and still haven't caught anything. But because you say so, I will let down the nets." When he trusted and did what Jesus said to do, the boat started to tip a little as the nets got heavier and heavier. Peter had never seen anything like it. The net filled with fish. He and Andrew tried to pull the net into the boat, but it was so heavy it started to break. So Peter called out, "James, John, come quick, help us." James and John hurried over in their boat to help. There were so many fish that both boats started to sink. Peter, Andrew, James, and John looked at the fish in amazement. There were so many fish. Peter looked at Jesus with wide eyes. Who was this man who could cause such amazing things to happen? Do you think Peter and the others would have experienced this amazing miracle had Peter not obeyed Jesus? Probably not. Peter began to realize who Jesus is and fell at his feet saying, "Go away from me, Lord, I'm a sinful man." Peter knew that he was a sinner, and compared to Jesus, who was perfect in every way, and without sin, Peter was so shameful. But Jesus replied, "Don't be afraid." Then Jesus said something very puzzling. Jesus said, "From now on, you will become fishers of men." Fishing and catching men instead of fish? Jesus meant that instead of catching fish, Simon, Andrew, James, and John would leave their nets and follow him instead. Jesus would teach them about who he is and why he came to earth. Then they would lead others to Jesus as well, just as Andrew had led Peter to Jesus. Jesus wanted them to be his followers and disciples and to learn from him. The four men had a choice to make. Would they give up everything and follow Jesus? The Bible says, "So they pulled their boats to shore, left everything, and followed him." You know, if Jesus asked you to leave your friends, your school, maybe even your family in order to obey and follow him, would you? Now, I'm not saying that Jesus would ask young kids like yourselves to leave their parents, but think about missionaries. Think about Miss Jenny's family and Jenna and Nicole's family. When Jesus told these families to leave Hope Church and go to Oakdale Church or go to Thailand to teach people there about God, they obeyed. I'm sure it was very difficult for them to leave family and friends at Hope Church, but when you obey Jesus, He honors your choice to follow Him. God has good things in store for us and only the best plans for us. We only need to trust and follow Him.